was so unusual that it's raining in Bonn that the organizers asked me to start a bit later. Okay, so yeah, so second lecture, Giuseppe Toscani, and we are going to continue with the Fokker plant model.
So let's start from the, let us repeat briefly what we discussed yesterday. So the idea was to find a simple microscopic model able to reproduce the normal distribution, which is a phenomenon, which is a distribution which is very well known and appears in many phenomena. So the idea was to use an interaction in which people modify the traits W to W star in terms of a function which is which has an expression that I will give again, and then of a random part that collects all the unpredictable part of the experiment of the interaction. The value function, which is written in the spirit of the prospect theory of Kahneman and Tversky, we choose is this one, this function, and this combined in such a way that when S, which is the fraction between W and the maximum value allowed, is less than 1, this is negative, and so you jump up. And when S is bigger than 1, then you jump down. So the effect is that when you are in a certain position, you decide to increase in a certain way, and this is easy. Or if you are above, you decide to decrease, and this is much more difficult. This is the spirit of the idea. And if you behave in this way, at the end, you end up with a Fokker plank, which is written here, in which there is a diffusion part with a coefficient W to the square and a drift which is due to the self-thinking of the agent, which is W log W over WL. So this was the arrival point. And the steady state of this Fokker plank equation is indeed a log normal density. So I'm not saying that this is the truth, since I'm not God. But in any case, I have an easy model from a microscopic point of view that leads to a kinetic model, and the kinetic model, the Gresham collision, limits lead to the Fokker-Planck equation, and this Fokker-Planck equation has a normal density. Yeah. So, and then, you know, we tried to see what happens with the service time, that was the first, but then we started to think about. And we discovered that there are many phenomena that can be reproduced using the same strategy. Yeah. The first one, someone is, I think, each one can understand easily. So for example, the body weight. Yeah. So we found many, so this is a very important question from the point of view of health. Yeah. And you know, many papers that we found are referred to risk analysis. Yeah. Someone is quite old, someone else is not so old. And the idea is that in all this paper, they notice that there is appearance of a normal distribution. Yeah. So the weight of people with respect to the ideal weight is exactly distributed like a log normal. Exactly is really strong. It means that the fitting is good with the log normal distribution, as we will see in the second part of this talk. But in any case, if we accept that the normal distribution appears, then the idea is very clear. Yeah? I tried to explain yesterday. It's written here. You know, you have an ideal weight, we all, and here, this is really human behavior. Yeah? When you are below the ideal weight, you are very happy. So you, this, for example, happened yesterday evening. To stop, you eat and drink. The drinking is concerned with the second part of this talk. Let's say alcohol consumption.
Yeah.
Now, for the moment, let's refer to the dessert, to the eating. And then the dramatic part is when you are oversized. Since to go back is not so pleasant. And the woman know. Yeah? And so the phenomenon is really skewed. When you are below, you are very happy to go above. When you are above, it's very difficult to go below. And so if you reproduce this by a value function, like the value function of the service done, you end up with the same Fokker-Planck equation. And you end up clearly, at this point, you understand the parameters which are responsible of your overweight. Yeah? And then you can handle the parameter in such a way that you can hope that it's better to produce some advertisement or to do something else. Yeah? This is the idea. To have a good model that depends clearly on few parameters allows to use the change of the parameters to tune the answer. But this is easy to understand. What is not so obvious is that the normal distribution appears when you're looking at the age of first marriage. Of this is something that was noticed many years ago by, so for example, Preston in a very important journal called Ecology. And one can say why one noticed that there is low normal distribution is strange. And also this is a skewed phenomenon. Since you know, suppose that you are looking at the age, then there is a balance in between the idea that to be single is very nice, and then there is some borderline which is connected with motherhood. And so you prefer to go up, but not to go too up. And see, if you are too up, it's difficult or clearly to go back. And so in a sense it appears that there is this bound. And usually, as you said, we present a picture which is referred to the marriage, the age of her marriage in the Milan city from 2001 to 2016, and it fits perfectly with normal density. Yeah. And then others. So, for example, drivers in traffic. There is this nice paper in which a certain number of authors, engineers, I think, they observed the red lights in Beijing, 3-4 red lights, cars starting during the day, and then they followed the number of cars in 1 hour, in 2 hours, and in 3 hours. And then they were looking at the reason why the distance between two cars, when leaving and when they are in some sort of steady state, were not normally distributed. And also this, that's usually a completely different model, by the way, but also this can be explained by this skewed distribution. In the sense that it's clearly, when you are very far from the car that you are in front, you accelerate to arrive to a certain distance, which is the optimal one. But clearly, and you are relaxed doing this. This is a driver, the good driver function. When you are close, too close, then you are worried, and then you start to decelerate. And this is not, so you have to be very careful with what you are doing. So the phenomenon is completely skewed. This is a normal distribution between the distance. That clearly can be evaluated counting the number of cars and the number of cars in a certain interval of space. And this is another interesting example. Consumption. There is this paper, this, let's say, recent paper, in which a number of economists studied the distribution of consumption. And what they noticed is that the income is not log normal. But consumption is much closer to log normal than income. And you say, I'm not an economist. Maybe I'm not a mathematician too. You know. But in any case, there is no need of 40 pages to justify that it's better to spend to have consumption than income. And I think that each one, when he's doing some shopping, understands perfectly the reason. You know? Yeah? So the it's clear. I hope so. And last, city size distribution. This is something that is well studied. And the fact that the skip, in principle, The largest part of all papers is devoted to fitting of the city of largest size, since it usually is believed that there is a so-called zip flow. They say that the number of cities which are over a certain size has a probability which is 1/(this size), eh? Which is not true at all. Eh? But then the core of the city distribution is exactly distributed like along normal well. And this in Italy is perfectly understandable, since usually the goal for people is to live in a city of middle size. And if you are in a small city, then you have the desire to go in a city of middle size. If you are in a city of too big, then there is this idea to go down. But this is much more difficult, since the increase of the number of people means to have new houses, so new, the money is circulating. When you go down, then there are areas that are not lived, and so this is a completely different phenomenon. So you can explain in this way, this disappearing. So we wrote a paper exactly on this, which is appearing now on physical, in which we justify immigration with a simple law, immigration and demigration, the fact that you are forming the core, which is long normal. Yeah. And this is, that's some picture of what we obtained. This is the situation of Italian cities. Let's say this is the core, is the normal core, and then you see there is a small part, which is, so the agents are split in two classes. The biggest class decides to go to live in a city of middle size, a much smaller class, around 4%, 4-5%, decides to live in a big city. Right? And the smallest class is represented here. And so what you get is this perfect fitting about when you join the two classes. Yeah? This is Italy, and you see, this is what you see at the level of fitting. You see, this is in log scale, which is almost perfect, and this is the one minus, this is the cumulative distribution function of Italy. And if you don't add this small part of people that wants to live in big cities, then you are perfect in the middle, in the core of the distribution, but then you start to be far when you are for very large cities. And so putting together the two distributions, but this is done only by the 4% of the people, that produces exactly this perfect agreement with the last part of the distribution. And this seems a phenomenon which is peculiar of Italy, so we tried also with Swiss, and even if Swiss is completely different with respect to his orographic structure, mountains and so on, but the situation perfectly fit in the same way, with a small part of people in Swiss is smaller, since there are no bigger cities in Swiss. This is the reason. And the fitting is almost perfect also in this way. You know, this is in a log scale, and then you see that you put a small part of population that lives in this situation, then you perfectly fit the distribution. And this is nice. When we send this paper to the journal, we had 4 referee reports. Since usually physics has a number of referees. 3 referees were agree with our way of explaining the phenomenon. The 4th referee say, oh, everything is known, since there are many papers with the fitting of this result. And so I asked them, I agree with you, there are many fitting, but no explanation of the fitting. And this makes a difference. If not, the fitting is God. Who can say that I can find another distribution and the fitting with W is better? No? So it means that if I know from the detail of the phenomenon, I can give you some answer. But in any case, 3-1, we succeeded to publish the paper.
Are there villages in your picture?
Huh?
Are there villages in your blocks?
Are
there villages?
There are also villages. The data in Italy have been collected by Istat, starting from villages from 100 people. And, But this is not a big problem, since you know the small villages are really a small part of the whole population. So they do not influence the community distribution function. They all are collected in this small part around one. So you don't see. There are not so many differences between Germany concerning small villages. The difference is with big cities. Yeah. This makes the difference. You know, like in Wales, if there are four big cities of 3 million of agents in a population of 50 million, it means that four cities have 20-25% of the whole distribution. So details are important here, more than the situation close to zero. And this is the picture, what happens in the age of first matches. This is a collection of all the data of the Milan municipality from 2001 to 2016. And you know, when you are in the log scale, and when you are, here is the distribution function, here the numbers are not very high. Is around 3,000-4,000. So it's surprising that you got an almost perfect picture, except in one point. And we talked about why this is not, you know, look this, and there is a place here that this is age increasing. So when you are here, you are around 70. And the reason is that in the last years, there are many women that decide to be married for the first time at 70 or more. This is funny. And if you look at the municipality of Milan, they are not a sensible percentage, but they exist. And in a number of 2,000-3,000, the fact that there are 100 clearly modified the distribution. So the fact that you start to be married at 70 for the first time has nothing to do with motherhood, of course. So the reason which is behind the formation of the normal distribution here is completely lost. But concerning the core, this is almost perfect. This is really fine. Okay. Let's now, if I may, go. So part two, what means part two? Essentially, when you understand that what you have in hand is a way to produce models, then you look around and you look for other phenomena that can be explained. So for example, by this log normal distribution, as I said before, there are many. But not all are described by the log normal distribution, clearly. And the exception are phenomena in which there is a deletion. So for example, alcohol consumption or gambling. These phenomena are completely, not completely different, but they are different. Yeah? And let me see. So this is a list of papers in which you can find the important are the third and the fourth. There are two preprints at the moment. In this paper, we try to understand which type of indication is in the behavior of humans determines the distribution of alcohol consumption. And this fourth is devoted to gambling. And so also in this paper, there is a part in which we discuss the presence of this new distribution about gambling. So two cases, alcohol consumption and gambling, and maybe many others. In any case, when there is addiction and when there are reasonable data about addiction, since they are not so easy to find, clearly. So for example, concerning alcohol consumption, you can find many data, except in Italy. So for example, we asked for data to Istat, and they never asked to us. Even if the data are in aggregate form, so there is no privacy at all, they didn't answer, so we wanted to fit exactly the time situation, but it was impossible. And so we refer to papers that are written in other parts of Europe in which the data are available. Yeah? And concerning gambling, the data are in the website of the web page of the site which is responsible for this gambling activity. They give the data in aggregate form, so here you can find it. So this is the motivation. The intese to paper, of course there are, let's say, dozens of papers and you can find almost everything in the medical or psychological literature. And so. You know, we insisted on this two paper written on population health metrics since this journal is exactly devoted to fitting. So to publish something here, you need to have some phenomenon, then you feed this phenomenon. It has to be concerned with health, of course, and alcohol consumption is concerned. And then there is this recent paper that collects the results of the first two and draws some conclusions. Yeah? And what we found? We found that the fitting of real data is such that you have a new, huge number of countries, I think in Tested to Paper 43 countries, including Africa countries and Europe countries and Eastern countries. And they have three types of fitting, gamma, variable, and they conclude that gamma and variable provide a better fitting with respect to the log normal distribution. So log normal was the usual one used to fit. Log normal is very easy, there are many programs that fit log normal distribution. Since this is, and this started with an interesting book by Lederman, Alcohol, Alcoholism and Alcoholization, in which you obtain this fitting in a clever way with log normal distribution. I have no time to explain why, but it is a very interesting idea. He didn't use any kinetic model, of course, but he says, suppose that the situation is well described by a log normal distribution, then you know, then the log normal distribution is given in terms of two parameters. The fact is that I cannot drink more than 1 liter of alcohol per day. So in a year, I cannot drink more than 365 liters of alcohol. This is the stop. And then the probability to go over is very small. And so you kill one of the two parameters with this idea. And then the second one, you fit. It was, you know, that it was written in 56, so it was difficult to use computers like we use now. So the fitting was a completely different question. But the idea is very interesting. Yeah. And concerning this type of result, yeah, one can say, can we describe, like we described, so for example, the log normal distribution forming at the level of agents, and to understand which type of value function have to use in this case to reproduce. Since you know, here you have a list of probability distribution, I think that maybe you are not so involved with this type of distribution, so I will present to you. So for example, this is the table. And you see, they do the fitting with log normal, and in log normal they use the mean and the standard deviation. Then they use gamma model, and they use the score and shape, they use the variable score and scale and shape. And the interesting part is this one, the shape is always below one, concerning variable and concerning also the gamma model. Why less than one, and which type of distribution are variable and gamma? Gamma is more popular, but variable is not so popular. So variable distribution is this one. You have an exponential part in which there is a parameter kappa bigger than zero. You have two parameters, kappa and theta. Kappa is the shape of parameter. If you take kappa equal one, then you have a distribution which is gamma. And the cap is the same. When you have k here, you have k minus 1 here. This is something that is interesting. When kappa is equal to 1, you have the exponential distribution. When kappa is equal to 2, you have the Rayleigh distribution with some sort of Gaussian in two dimensions, restricted to dimension 1. And usually, variable gives a distribution for which the failure rate of some mechanism is proportional to a power of time. This is the distribution that you get. And then gamma is given in terms of the same parameter, but here k can be less, bigger than zero, and here the exponent is equal to one. So the fact that k is less than one in all the fitting means simply that this k is less than one in the gamma. So it's a function that goes to zero. Not so. There are many. The distribution is very. If you plot the distribution, when kappa is less than one, this x goes to the denominator, so it's increasing around zero. Speaking in terms of wealth, if you have a distribution of this type, you have a large class of poor people. And so speaking in terms of alcohol consumption, it means that you have a lot of people which is not drinking too much, more or less. And this is the same for Bible. This is the case k less than one. When k less than one, this goes to the denominator. The difference in Bible is concerned with the large consumers. Large consumers use this part of the distribution when you go up. And with Weibull, you have a larger part of large consumers. So this is more or less the model. And then all this distribution belong to a bigger class, which you find if you go on Wikipedia and you look for generalized gamma distribution. Then you look that the generalized gamma is given in terms of three parameters. The one parameter is the exponent on the exponential, the second parameter is k, and the third parameter is this theta, which appears. Yeah? And so, all the distribution that the people involved in this population and metric papers used particular cases of the generalized gamma. So, the case in which, instead of do the fitting with three parameters, you do the fitting with two parameters. Since you know, gamma density, you fix one parameter delta equal to 1. Weibull density, you fix delta equal k. And here is not written, but also the log normal distribution fits in this case. And it is obtained when delta goes to 0. It's the limit delta to 0. So log normal distribution is a particular case, limit case of the generalized gamma distribution. So the object that I want to reproduce is exactly this one, this generalized gamma. And then I use log normal distribution I taught. Then I use the same trick I used in the first part. Let's say I try to understand which type of value function are producing this type of distribution. And this is not difficult, since the reason is always the same, except the particulars. So essentially, alcohol consumption depends on many variables, but in any case, there is some sort of, let's say, addiction when you cross a certain value for a certain time. Then it's difficult to go back. And then there is also some sort of social attitude. So each one of us is drinking one or two, let's say, unity of alcohol a day, let's say one beer, one glass of wine or so. So if you stay there, you are not so bad. At least I know this is my mother, so survived up to 95 drinking wine. Okay? One glass. Unlikely, we succeed. Since my alcohol consumption is much bigger, so you know. In any case, no, this is a serious problem which is related to health. When you cross and we arrive at the last part of the distribution, this is a serious problem. So, and so there is some sort of small value, which is the social barrier, let's say 1 to unity a day, which is accepted, universally accepted. And then there is, like in the service time, there is another dangerous, let's say, barrier, which is W bar L, which is bigger than W, which is some sort that it would be better not to exist. And then you have the tendency to increase, and then when you cross, there is some tendency to decrease, but in this case it's much more difficult with respect to the service time. This justifies the difference of the distribution. And so we use the same interaction. Let's say this is your alcohol consumption, and this is the value function. And then we use it. We start from this value function, which is the exponential of epsilon s minus 1 minus 1. I will explain why. So when you are bigger than s is bigger than 1, so you are above, then this function is positive. When you are below the value 1, then this function is negative. And this function is a function which is satisfies exactly all the conditions of Kahneman and Tversky. Let's say it's a bounded function which is positive and concave above the reference value and negative and convex below. It's some sort of function which some curve of this type. Yeah? And of course, this can be. It satisfies the same property of the other value function, and this can be easily generalized, putting an exponent delta here, when delta goes from 0 to 1. So we have a list of value functions which depends on this parameter delta, and this delta is connected with the power that you put in the exponential. It seems a little artificial, but the fact is that this sequence of functions interpolate between phi 1 and phi 0, and phi 0 is the function that has been imposed below together of normal distribution. Yeah? Remember that normal distribution is attained when delta goes to 0 in the generalized gamma. And this is a typical picture when delta is less than 1. There are functions which are obtained in this way. And when you are, 0 is corresponds to s equal 1, it clearly indicates that when you are below, at the same distance, you are here, 1 minus delta s or 1 plus delta s, then the level, the possibility to increase is much bigger than the possibility to decrease. So this is the spirit of all the value function. You increase easily, starting at the same distance, you decrease, more difficult if you are above. And this is exactly what is written here. So, like it happens in the service time or in all the other situations. This is another addition. That maybe we can reproduce some model about the use of the formula. I never talked to this, but I will do. In any case, you write the same kinetic Boltzmann kinetic equation. This is the one. Then you plug, you understand that when epsilon is very small, your value function can be written like epsilon times mu over 2 delta is delta to minus 1. And when you are considering grazing collision, the Fokker plug that you get is exactly this one. You have the same diffusion part with W to the power 2, and then you have a different drift here, which is given in terms of this function, in which there is this fraction can then be positive or negative depending on whatever you are. This is the Fokker plug, the arrival Fokker plug that describes the last part.
What is tau?
Is some relaxation time.
Which is not epsilon.
Is epsilon. No, no, but here is here there is no epsilon. Here this is Boltzmann. And then tau is tau. Take tau equal 1. So it's some relaxation to study numerically the equation. This is. Then when you pass to 0, clearly you have to scale time. So the procedure is the same of the procedure of yesterday, so I don't insist on this. But in any case, If you plug epsilon small and then time, change time. So this is misleading since yesterday you used to as a new time. So forget about this talk. This is the arrival Fokker-Planck equation, which this is the intensity of the random part, and this is the intensity of the limit values from above and below. You know, there is this delta. And if you look, as always, you plug a sort of boundary condition. I don't insist on this, but you know that they are very important for the mathematical treatment of this type of equation, like we will see tomorrow. Then you can look for the stationary solutions. The stage of resolution can be found by solving this differential equation of first order. Then you apply H of W equal W. So this is an exercise. And what you find is that the steady state has some normalization constant. If not, it's not the days. That is W over WL to some exponent. And not that this exponent is gamma over delta minus 2. And to be consistent with the generalized gamma, this exponent has to be bigger than 1. bigger. This is k minus 1, the usual representation. So gamma over delta has to be bigger than 1. If not, it doesn't work. And this gives a bound on delta with respect. So when delta is small, this is clearly obtained for a small value of gamma. If delta is not so small, you need a certain amount of randomness in your procedure to arrive to a consistent. And then there is this exponent. And this is clearly exactly a generalized gamma density, which describe the parameter in terms of the microscopic parameters of the interaction. Yeah? So a generalized gamma density is a consequence of the choice of a certain value function. And delta equal to 1 represents gamma, and delta equal to 1 gives you the V1 in this description. This one. This function gives you the gamma. This function gives you a generalized gamma function, and when delta goes to 0, then you get a log normal distribution. So you have a complete picture of the way of getting the generalized gamma density. And the generalized gamma density can be written, of course, can be written in this way, and this gives you the meaning of the parameter k. The parameter k, which is the scale parameter, is gamma over delta minus 1, and the theta is written in this way. And you can obtain gamma density when delta is equal to 1, vibor density when delta is equal to kappa. And if you perform the limit delta to 0, both in the Fokker-Planck equation, and so gives you a limit in the drift, or you can do the limit directly on the generalized gamma, and for delta to 0 you reobtain the log normal density. So why log normal density is not so good? The fact is that log normal density depends on when is given when delta goes to 0, but the right expression in all the fitting that they did is given in terms of delta. And indeed, it's given in terms of k. For vibor distribution, delta is equal to k is less than 1, but it's not close to 0, which is the case of the log normal distribution. So the log normal distribution is a limit situation, but the data of the fitting say that kappa, which is equal to delta, for example, in the vibor, is not 0. It's less than 1, but it's not 0. So log normal is not. Give not a perfect fitting. Yeah. And overall, it gives not a perfect fitting around 0. Since you know when k is less than 1, you have this accumulation that there are a lot of people which are drinkers, social drinkers, which are close to 0, and they do not believe to the addiction part of the distribution. This, more or less, I think, is the real. Of course, it would be nice to speak with some medicine involved in this matter to understand if there is something reasonable on this or not. And this is something that we didn't do at the moment. And here there are some idea about discussion of the parameters. We have the parameter delta to 0, and the moment are given in terms of this bound that is better not to cross, and delta, lambda, which is the random part, and mu, which denotes the value characterizing the value function. And this is all. So more or less we were happy. Now the problem that was not studied at the moment, so tomorrow I will speak about mathematical problem involved, and this maybe is the most interesting part of this let's say, description of human activity. Since there is some unexpected consequences in terms of the study of the Fokker-Planck equation that I hope to be able to outline. But in any case, there is something which is not clear, since what we are doing here is to take a kinetic model, so to provide a kinetic description, but then the results are given only in terms of the Fokker-Planck equation. And so, how can we be sure that the kinetic description is close to the Fokker-Planck description and that the steady state is close to the steady state? This is something that, so for, in the kinetic model, the interaction is not difficult, but there is nothing which is preserved except the mass. So it's difficult to extract conclusion on the steady state. Eh? And so let's try numerically to see what happens. Eh? Numerically means that you have two possibilities. One is to check if our fitting with, there is a particular generalized gamma distribution that gives the best fitting. But this is a very difficult problem, since the generalized gamma distribution has three parameters, and to find an optimal with three parameters is something which is very difficult to obtain. We are thinking about how to solve, or at least how to try some method investigating the fitting in such a way that we can find the best distribution, but at the moment we don't know how to do. If someone is interested, you can look about statistical methodology, this paper in which they explain why the generalized gamma distribution depending on three parameters is very difficult to provide a good fitting. But in any case, you see, here there is an experiment in which we started, this experiment is done on the kinetic model with Monte Carlo method. Giacomo Di Marco is an expert of this, and you know, we have the initial data, which is this step function, and then f infinity, which is written in red, this red, is the f infinity, and then we choose the different value of the parameter epsilon. So consider that when epsilon is very small, we are practically in the Fokker-Planck regime, but, you know, look what happens when epsilon is equal to 0.5. Then there is a part which is not which is bad, there is some difference. But then if you take epsilon 0.1, so 1 over 10, so you are not in the Fokker-Planck regime, since the Fokker-Planck regime is epsilon to 0, but you don't see differences between the steady state of the Boltzmann equation and of the Fokker-Planck equation. So it means that both equations gave a picture of the same steady state. It's not necessary to take epsilon very small. When epsilon is equal, so 1 over 10 is a usual parameter. Yeah? And you are very, very, very close. And this is done so with a certain values of the parameters which determines the value function. And here I change the parameters, you know, in this case, the function is exactly one function, like viable distribution, in which there is accumulation of people which is not drifting too much around zero. But also in this case, I start with the same, and when epsilon is equal to 0.1, you don't see any difference between the steady state and likely the colors are not perfectly understandable. And this is another situation in which we use a different delta very small, very close to one, and the same phenomenon happens. It's enough to take epsilon equals 0.1, it gives you, clearly the picture is a little different, but maybe here you have to wait much more time. But in case that the profile is more or less the same. Yeah? And this is the same picture changing parameters. Yeah? So this closes the modeling part of what I wanted to say to you. Mm? More interestingly, there is a mathematical part. Now I see that maybe I have 10 minutes so I can start, and this is a consistent part, and I don't know if I will have time to present all things. So this was the modeling part, now let us see what happens and if we can justify the fact that if we wait enough time, what we see is the steady profile. And let's try to understand if we see the steady profile, which is what people say sees when it's doing some fitting. In other words, this profile is reached exponentially in time. This seems a simple matter, but it's not. Since one has to deal with Fokker-Planck equations which are linear, of course, but the coefficient of diffusion, the fixed coefficient are not linear. And the classical example is the Fokker-Planck equation for well distribution that was resistant to the proof of exponential convergence to equilibrium. So I will speak before of the case of the normal density. This case is clear and gives you some idea of how to proceed in all the other cases. Then I will speak about the case of the well distribution, where the steady state is in an inverse gamma function. You know, from all the discussion of today, maybe you understand that at the end, with this type of Fokker-Planck equation, you can obtain any distribution on R plus you want, simply playing with drift and the coefficient of diffusion. So the idea is that all this type of Fokker-Planck equation has the same asymptotic behavior or not. And surprisingly, it's not. And then I will speak in a second part of something that has never been touched before. Let's say all what we said yesterday and today was based on the assumption that our model was a Maxwellian model. Let's say the collision kernel was taken equal to 1 or taken equal to constant. In a sense, all the interactions have the same value. And if you think about, so for example, concerning well distribution, this is not so. We present an example. And this is not so in the alcohol consumption. So it's much more easier to pass from 0 to epsilon than to pass from 1 to 1 plus epsilon. Let's say that people, or one is not drinking at all, or to pass from drinking 0 to drinking 1 glass of wine, is much more popular than pass from 10 to 20. So this means that you have to plug inside something that determines. And the funny story is that if you arrive to the same type of equation by the mean field, then you can, of course. So for example, the equation for well, the distribution has been obtained before by Bouchoux and Mézard, exactly starting from a stochastic differential equation. You have not this possibility. The possibility to choose a collision kernel is exactly given if you are looking at the kinetic description, not at the limit description. So this makes some difference. And I hope you will appreciate that the kinetic theory is much more powerful than limit theory, at least in this concerning this. And so I will speak about non-Maxwellian model and about the last time behavior of this non-Maxwellian model and other examples. And the first two papers, the first one is always the same paper in which we, let's say, summarize all this type of Fokker-Planck equation. Then there is a second one which contains the second part and which is really, this is a preprinted, the present version, which is right about Fokker-Planck equation in the case of non-Maxwellian interaction, and then the mathematical part about the normal distributions contained in this paper written with Stefano Guarardi. And then there is this paper in which I noticed that you have this possibility to study sharp inequalities for probability density on the line simply using Fokker-Planck, and this is something that I'm writing. It's not available at the moment, but in any case I will give some hint. So, as I said yesterday, when I wrote this Fokker-Planck equation with this logarithmic drift, the first attempt was to see if in the literature this equation was present. And I didn't find. So I find that many other papers. So for example, I find Fokker-Planck equation with logarithmic factors in diffusion and drift terms, which were written here, but it's not this equation. The presence of the logarithm in the diffusion coefficient is something that is not connected with what we are seeing, since here the logarithmic part is in the drift. And in any case, this type of equation was derived still in the field of econometric physics. So it means that this mathematical modeling of, let's say, economic experiments give rise to a sort of variety of equations that are connected with logarithmic diffusion, with logarithmic drift, and so on. And moreover, there is an interesting paper by Cordier, Pareschi, and Piatecchi in which the log normal distribution appears not like a steady state, but like a self-similar solution of a model of market. But you know, self-similar solution of, which gives you rise to the log normal diffusion are very easy. So for example, there is this equation which represents the so-called geometric Brownian motion, in which you are in R plus and you have a coefficient of diffusion which here there is this blue square. And this equation is has a self-similar solution, which is a log normal distribution that starts with a delta in one and then it expands like a log normal depending on time. This is a very well-known fact. What is not so well known is that you can obtain a transformation of variable to reduce this equation to the Hitt equation. And this gives you a representation of the solution in terms of the Gaussian, and then when you go back, you obtain the representation in terms of the log normal distribution. In any case, if you look at the method, then you can argue that maybe this Fokker-Planck equation is connected to the Gaussian too. And the classical Fokker-Planck equation is written here, is written in this way. You have diffusion, a constant coefficient of diffusion, in this case I choose one. Then there is a constant here, which is one over the temperature. This is the classical way in which one writes the Fokker-Planck equation. And then you have a linear drift. And clearly, when you are looking for the steady state of field equation, this steady state of field equation is a Maxwellian equilibrium. Or, since I'm speaking about probability densities, is a normal density, a Gaussian density. And the parameter that appears in the equation, 1 over t, appears here like this, the second moment, and m, which appears in the drift, is the mean of the Gaussian density. And then, suppose that I have my equation with logarithmic drift, suppose that they have no flux boundary condition, and so, once I have this type of boundary condition, I know that the solution of my Fokker-Planck equation remains a probability density for all time. So, conditions on zero are very important to go over, to be sure that the mass is not decreasing, that the mass is not increasing. So you need, at least you need this no-flux condition to say that the mass remains in the interval in which you are. And then, write an equivalent formulation in terms of G infinity. In our case, G infinity is a log normal distribution. Let's say this is another way to write the joint equation, and it gives an explanation why. This is the equilibrium. The equilibrium satisfies this equation. Let's say the flux is zero corresponding to equilibrium. And then, when you write this part, you can write this like extracting G. You can extract like w square g, and then you have the derivative of the logarithm plus 1 over w, the derivative of this. And if you don't have the equation, maybe it's difficult to follow this. But in any case, you can write this expression in a different way. Let's say the same diffusion, g infinity, derivative with respect to v of g over g infinity, or which independently of the form of the steady state, you can always write the Fokker-Planck equation like derivative with respect to W of this part, which depends on the coefficient of diffusion, with respect to W of the log of G. G is the quotient between F and the equilibrium. And or in this other way, if you plug here G infinity, and then instead of having the derivative of the logarithm, you have the derivative of G. In any case, if you write the evolution equation for the quotient, the evolution equation for the quotient is written in such a way that the coefficient go outside. This is a very standard way. This is a school, so believe me, you do the exercise. And if you look in books about, let's say, parabolic equation, this is the usual form that they use. Let's say the derivative of something with respect to g is some sort of function which multiplies the second derivative. This function, you see, is bigger or equal than zero, so it's not fully parabolic since there is a point zero in which there is no diffusion at all. But this is naturally not massive move on the other side. And then you have another function which multiplies it. So this is the joint equation, and it's simply connected with the original equation through the quotient between g and g infinity. Clearly, to write this quotient, it means that you have some sort of, you have to choose some sort of initial data which have a certain number of properties, if not, you can't. But at least from a formal point of view, this is what you can write, and I will stop here now. And then the boundary condition, move to the boundary conditions for capital G. In particular, this is interesting since there is capital G with respect to W and the steady state that you know. So this simply means that you need some sort of decay to zero when you are in the boundary zero. And this is a joint equation, since it's classical for people working in parabolic equations, with this function called A of X, and with this function called B of X. Has been studied by William Felder in a clever paper on the annals of math in 1952. It's a long paper in which he uses the semigroup theory to prove that if you have a certain number of properties on the coefficient of diffusion, you have a certain number of properties on the coefficient of drift, then you can obtain the fundamental solution of your problem, and then you can have a lot of properties, then this solution satisfies a certain number of boundary conditions. So I say the funny story, as I said yesterday, is that Feller started to study this problem, studying in -1, 1, this was the original idea, the so-called Fisher-Wright equation, which is an equation in genetics that was very popular at that time. And then, you know, any mathematician is generalizing, and he generalized. But there are no physical examples of systems, of course you can find from biological application, but there were no many physical applications. But it's a fantastic paper. Essentially, there is almost nothing to do. Any time that you know that your coefficient fit in the analysis of Feller, you have everything. So at least from the mathematical point of view, here there is nothing to do. And tomorrow we will see what was missing in the analysis of Feller. So I think that we can stop here.
Any question, comments?
I would like to know about the derivation of the equation for capital G. Which kind of, if any, conservation properties do you need to derive that equation? Only the mass conservation, or do you also need the mean conservation?
This is a nice question. In principle, if you start from the adjoint equation, this is an equation that you can derive, incidentally. The equivalence between the two required existence of some moment. Since you need a certain decay at infinity, and you need a certain decay at the boundary.
But for instance, but no conservations. I mean, if you have a mean which is not conserved, you
No. But in this type of Poincaré equation, the mean is not preserved.
Okay. Thank you.
The mean is preserved when you have a linear drift, and then you start exactly with the mean. So it's the only case in which the mean is preserved.
I have another question to the modeling on the small side. So in your alcohol model, you had mainly social drinkers and people who are kind of close to addiction. But I believe that in the general population there is a serious part who are teetotal, who don't drink anything.
I didn't understand the last part of your.
So there are people who don't drink, who drink zero alcohol.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah.
And they are not involved in this, and I said,
yeah, so they so you can just throw them away, this is the way to model them, not to ignore them, yes.
Then there is a certain part, which is, let's call it, that they are doing some social drinking. Let's say they are usually drink something, but not too much, so that they do not fall in a serious health problem, and they are not essentially not studied by this analysis. But you know, when they are looking at the distribution of alcohol consumption, they invite people to answer to some questionnaire, and also people which is drinking one glass a day, right, one glass a day. So at the end they are included in this picture. But the important part is the part which moves close to this health level, which has not to be overcrossed. So all the analysis done by the guys was exactly concerned with this part of high drinkers. But you know, when you are looking at the distribution of alcohol consumption, you are looking at all the distribution, starting from zero up to the maximum amount of consumption.
Okay, so let's thank Giuseppe again.